Good evening. Hundreds of homes are flooded tonight and power in the CBD could be cut for days as this deadly rain bomb bears down on the southeast. There's been destruction on the Brisbane River as untethered boats and pontoons floated away. One man was rescued in dramatic scenes.
Carried by an unforgiving torrent.
Oh, no.
A houseboat with a man still on it.
Jump off. Is he going to jump off?
And then horror.
He's going to jump off, right?
Oh!
Get off! Get off! Get off! Get off! Get off!
The boat flips and is sucked underwater. It and the man carried by the raging water from Kangaroo Point to Howard Smith Wharves, where he's spotted clinging to the wharf, there bystanders pulling him from the water. That's him being freed, the man in his 70s miraculously surviving and even walking away.
The big houseboat just came screeching through, smashed into it, and it disintegrated into pieces.
The mighty Brisbane River is menacing. The force of these floods picking up whatever it can. Pontoons pulled downstream, breaking ferry terminals in half.
Look at that.
And crashing into bridges. The heart of Brisbane covered in debris, complete destruction. The river rose rapidly, suburbs, homes and residents at its mercy.
So the water from Norman Creek has come through the house, through under the house, and is now flooded the rest of the street.
Parts of Toowong and Milton are underwater. In Auchenflower, a lone kayaker saved this family who can't swim.
We were talking to him and he offered his help and here we are, thanks to him.
These St. Lucia residents are trapped in their apartments.
So this was your reception area?
Yeah, that's the entry to the building. We were expecting a little bit of water. There was some last night, but this was a little deeper than we were expecting.
Roads, now rivers, cars submerged, homes inundated.
My bedroom. So we've recently renovated and made an inside pool.
Residents packed up what they could as soon as they could. Dorothy White's house was hit in 2011. She's not taking any chances this time.
Came up about 6 inches, came in all in under the house. We're going now before we have to be taken out.
The flood claimed a man's life in Indooroopilly overnight after his car became submerged. In Graceville, the water came slowly but surely.
We've just been watching since about 2 o'clock yesterday. We've watched the water get worse and worse.
This family and their pets had to be rescued.
They're relieved to have the dogs out. And that's the most important thing. And the kids.
Drivers risked it in Newstead.
Oh, my God.
In Hawthorne, debris is piling up fast. This ferry terminal smashed.
Unfortunately, all those boats are just pushed up against each other, smashed. Like hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of boats.
This was Jill Taylor's street in Oxley.
Everybody kept saying it's never going to happen again, 2011, but here we are.
Residents here are worried. They're already seeing the impact of early dam releases and there will be more to come.
We'll probably end up with another metre and a half of water. We're just hopeful that it doesn't go up to floor level.
We're going to see these high levels for the next 3 days.
One of the big concerns for residents here is just how quickly the water level has risen. We're standing here in a backyard which, as of 5 hours ago, had next to no water on it, but as you can see, it's risen more than a foot within that time. Hundreds of schools have already been closed.
And I also encourage people to work from home tomorrow.
Public bus and ferry services are also suspended. Power could be cut for days in some areas. For some, a kayak is the only way around. This rain bomb unrelenting. Ben Murphy, 7 News.
Joel Dry is at the Hawthorne Ferry Terminal tonight. Joel, what a mess.
Yeah, Max, it really is. We are where those pictures were showing just a few minutes ago here at the Hawthorne Ferry, and things have got decidedly worse. For a lot of the debris that got held up at Kangaroo Point, if you missed there, this was another collection area, and there is boats, there are yachts, there are white goods, there is general rubbish, and also a number of city cats are just parked to the other side of the Hawthorne Ferry in some effort to keep them safe from this raging torrent. The water is rising rapidly. We were here about half an hour ago, and the water has come up at least 30 metres from where we had intended to set up. We are now almost knee-deep in water. There have been some people out sightseeing. Obviously, they are very nervous about the situation, so they want to get a better sense of what is exactly going on. A number of homes on this street, Gordon Street, they are getting water up through the bottom of their stormwater drains. They are having to bail out. And the obvious question is, when will the waters peak? That still remains to be seen, because as you can see, the water is still absolutely teeming down.
Well, we're upstream from you, Joel, and I can tell you there is more debris on the way to you. Let's go to Georgie Trumley now, who's at Woolowin. Georgie, hundreds of homes have been inundated across the suburbs.
Max, that's right. It's absolutely incredible scenes. We've seen residents boated out of their homes, not knowing when they'll come back or what they'll come back to. This afternoon, the Prime Minister announcing disaster relief funds of $1,000 per adult, $400 per child, which is a welcome relief. But the biggest concern tonight is getting people out of inundated areas before high tide. Street after street, suburb after suburb, rescue after rescue. At Windsor, the SES was sent in to see if anyone was stranded. They were, dozens of them. Desperate missions made by the desperately tired. Boats going in empty, coming out full.
We're in a state of shock at the moment. We're just caught out a little bit, but it's at least we're safe. So that's the main thing. We've got the dog out as well.
Those inside, thankful they weren't left behind.
So it's just about to reach our veranda now, so we're about to get it in our house.
We had no idea. Our neighbours were saying that the 2011 floods didn't get this high.
Georgia Roach and her partner heeded warnings to seek higher ground, but even their boat is flooded.
Dogs are out, everything's out, packed a bag.
How are you going? Is this all a bit of a shock?
Of course, yeah. We're okay, we've got some beautiful people who have helped us a lot today.
There's so much water with nowhere to go. In Albion this morning, the only path left was through homes and businesses, destroying livelihoods, changing lives.
We got here early and just trying to move stuff up. The quickest we could move it up, it was just getting flooded in. There's nothing we can do.
2011 was bad, but for some, this is worse. Phil has lost $80,000 worth of stock from his tiling business. The damage inside, hard to comprehend.
What about later? Yeah, when the tide changes again and they release the dam, supposedly, so hopefully not too much more. Hopefully it stops raining.
That was never going to happen. The rain kept tumbling.
Holy
Rocklea felt the wrath too. Roads were rivers. Even in unbelievable weather, unbelievably, drivers were choosing to risk it. In Chermside, the water was churning. Backyards lost beneath raging rivers. At Toombul, sirens sounded. The shopping centre was evacuated, nowhere immune. Kate Webster's had to move her livestock to under the house. She won't get out for days.
Forget about swimming with dolphins. We were swimming with stray dogs and donkeys here yesterday. All you can do is just sit on the veranda and just watch it go past.
Bow Desert is anything but. Panic has settled in and panic buying has started. In West End, the shelves are running bare as Brisbane bunkers down. Georgie Chumley, 7 News.
So here are some key points you need to know this hour. Schools in the flood zones will be closed tomorrow, with people urged to work from home. Residents are being told to conserve water after Mount Crosby and North Pine water treatment plants went offline. However, SEQ Water says the current drinking water is safe. Flooding is expected to continue for at least the next 3 days. In Brisbane, an evacuation centre has opened in Chandler Arena at the Sleeman Sports Complex. There's also one at the Kedron Wavell Services Club in Chermside. Public transport services, including buses and city cats, have been cancelled. Wivenhoe Dam is at 177% capacity. Well, let's bring in Kendall Gilding now. She's at the North Side Evacuation Centre, that's at Chermside. Kendall, council opened its second evacuation site just hours ago.
Max, this is the Kedron Wavell Services Club. It only started welcoming people at 2 p.m. and in just 4 hours, it is nearing capacity. Some people have had to flee their homes because they're unlivable due to floodwaters. Other people have simply become cut off by the many road closures across the region.
We obviously just want to get home, but just accepting the situation is what it is. I mean, thankfully we're safe here.
The advice for people who do need to seek refuge is to bring essentials, things like a phone and charger, toiletries, spare clothes and food before you arrive. As you mentioned, Max, that other evacuation centre is in operation at the Sleeman Sports Complex in Chandler for people who are on the south side. Council says they will open more evacuation centres if needed.
Let's hope they're not there too long. Thanks for that, Kendall. Bringing in Sally Guyatt now, who's at Ipswich, and if anything, it seems to be getting stronger out there.
Well, Max, even in the last few minutes, it's as heavy this rainfall as we've seen all day, and it's contributing to this. The Bremer River, which has well and truly broken its banks and is now absorbing a part of Ipswich CBD where we are this evening. But it's really down the road that is tonight truly ground zero for this flood emergency in this region, and that's Goodna.
Oh no, oh no, that's another one.
All the warnings, all the water. Still the alert for Ipswich didn't sound until 1:30 this morning. Police and the SES were swift to act by 3 a.m. closing roads, taking residents from their homes.
These are all volunteers, remember, who come out for fires, rescues, floods.
We're doing the best we can. This is my second one down here. We did the 2011 floods down here as well, so not at that height yet, and fingers crossed it's not going to be at that height.
Not yet, but it is still rising.
Just pray first. Just pray. Thank you.
By 11:30, the flood gauge hit 11 metres, creeping towards that 2011 level of 16.5 metres.
Yeah, we just check our things to put it up.
Jacinta Samet's grandmother's house went under in 1974, 2011, now again in 2022.
How's Grandma doing now?
In denial. She doesn't think it's happening, but it is.
In a matter of hours, this water has gone from ankle deep to knee deep and even higher. Residents along this street are moving their items to higher ground or removing them altogether. Experience doesn't make this easier. In some ways, it makes it worse. The people of Goodna still haven't settled their class action after 2011.
I hope this is a time for people to pull their finger out and make sure they make a decision and make sure the people of Goodna actually get their money.
This time around, the Mud Army hasn't waited for waters to recede.
As soon as we got the phone call, we just basically got ready and we left straight away.
Evacuation centres at Kruger State School and the showgrounds, places of refuge, despair, but also hope.
We've bought the pets, you know, our family and, you know, all the important things.
In the heart of the city, a production line of helpers shifted stock from Ipswich Day and Night Chemist. They've gone under before and won't risk it again. The Bremer River hit 14.5 metres and rising, below the 2011 record of 19.4, still an anxious wait. Tonight's high tide isn't until 10 o'clock. Sally Guyatt, 7 News.
Well, from Ipswich to Logan, Katrina Blowers, Logan residents are bracing for major flooding tonight. How high do authorities think it will get?
Well, Max, all day here at the Logan River, those river levels have just been rising rapidly, spearing dangerous debris downstream. But that hasn't stopped one man from jumping on a jet ski and racing upstream, dodging logs and branches in an act of extreme stupidity. Council has issued emergency alerts for 16 suburbs, with flood peaks expected at close to 2017 levels, which was the worst local flood in memory. The Logan Logan River at McLean Bridge, expecting to peak at 20.5 metres tonight. At Waterford, that peak will arrive tomorrow morning at 9 metres. There's currently moderate flooding along the Albert River and minor flooding at Beenleigh. Conditions there are expected to deteriorate tonight also. But it is really the Logan River that authorities say is the one to watch. And Council has spent the day door knocking suburbs that are expected to be worst affected. There are 16 suburbs on that list. And 2017, not that long ago, after Cyclone Debbie just brought a huge amount of rain to this area and devastated businesses and homes. So it really will be an anxious wait for so many people tonight.
They're not alone. Thanks for that, Katrina. We've finally been able to make our way into Grantham to show you firsthand the devastation. The town remains an island with residents evacuated and 150 roads cut.
Sheltering at the pub, CWA nursing home residents shifted into the Oakey RSL after an emergency alert for Oakey Creek.
Day three for Grantham.
The rain came and it stayed.
And it's like a highway of water.
Alan Baxter had hoped to ride out the ordeal, but was today evacuated from town.
There's no fresh water to drink.
At Bill Hooper's Grantham shop.
Here we are on like our own little island.
More damage and devastation, but above all, generosity. The owner giving away a cold room full of food.
Milk and eggs.
Selflessness during a disaster. The strongest display of that shown in Grantham yesterday when Jamie Dixon pulled Leo from raging floodwaters in an extraordinary rescue.
Bobbing up and down in the water, and there was times when I thought he was gone completely.
Graham Turnbull was also there and called 000.
He couldn't talk. He couldn't respond.
Leo has since been discharged from Gatton Hospital.
You do these things to help your fellow man.
Well, this road has just reopened this afternoon, allowing hundreds of residents who live in Placid Hills and have been stuck for 2 days to get in and out of Gatton for supplies.
But 147 roads do remain closed across the Lockyer Valley.
This water here is still flowing, and this fence through here is how you get up to back of Wall's property there, and that's all the dams are busted.
Meaning people like Dawson Hobbs and neighbour Wally Maguire, who live at Lower Tent Hill, remain cut off.
The shed, tractors is underwater.
Inside.
That's all mud. That's not black tiles.
What colour are they usually?
What?
The inevitable wait for the dreaded clean-up.
Now, I've just checked in with the Lockyer Valley Regional Council following their disaster briefing this afternoon. They say they are still monitoring this situation. They can't be confident that the risk is over yet. Their focus certainly remains still on public safety rather than recovery efforts just yet. And tonight, those 147 roads still remain cut around the region.
All right, thanks, Emily. Now to the Gold Coast, where the flood threat is intensifying as we go to air tonight. Josh Riveridge, the system is set to peak there at midnight.
Max, Gold Coast City Council has been told the most intense rainfall will strike in the middle of the night, and at this stage there are no forced evacuations, but meeting points are being set up at Reedy Creek and Ulmo. And due to COVID, for those who can't return home, accommodation vouchers will be handed out in order to keep them away from the danger zone.
It's coming from the north. Birds Road barely recognisable. Water crushing cane fields. Police escorting a long line through the danger zone on Norwell Road. This is what police want to avoid. The torrent starts here, high in the hinterland. 219 millimetres has fallen at Mount Tambourine and through the streets.
A waterfront one off, waterfront view as well.
It's pretty insane.
Curtis Falls Cafe, a casualty.
It was at least a foot under yesterday and it was all inside.
This flowing into the upper reaches of the Logan and Albert Rivers. Its sheer force bending trees at Wongawallen, Hins Dam. Now at 117% and rising. Dreamworld too dangerous to open.
We were the outside of Wet and Wild, and it's like a flood is everywhere outside.
All 40 beaches closed too.
There's a lot of wind and very rough water, so mixed up with that you'll see there's a lot of debris and froth.
An official call will be made tomorrow, but with days worth of runoff still to make its way downstream, it's unlikely beaches along the coast will reopen anytime soon.
A cascade in Carrara. 25 roads are currently closed, including the route to Narangwood.
Yeah, kind of stuck out of home at the moment. Hoping to get back before tomorrow so I can go to work.
More waits likely in days to come. On the Gold Coast, Josh Ribrich, 7 News.
And poor Bert is at Oxenford tonight. Bertie, there are warnings for the Coomera River.
Yes, that's right there, Maxie. In fact, we've had more than 200 millimetres falling overnight in the Coomera catchment area around Beachmont and, of course, Mount Tambourine. And it's all powering out through this area here at the Weir. Now, the Oxenford Weir, we've seen floodwater here for almost a week, but nothing quite like this. The Coomera River has broken through a second section of the north. It's draining all that floodwater at an incredible rate, I can assure you of that. It's a moderate flood height for this waterway. Now, we are being urged and warned that there could be further rises throughout the night if there is continued rainfall higher up in the catchment area. There's also warnings in the cities south around Talabudja and, of course, Currumbin, residents there in low-lying areas later tonight if this rain continues to fall.
All right, thanks, Bertie. Now to Tony Auden, and this rain is still having a big impact. The big question, Tony, how much longer do you expect it to last?
Well, Max, that clock is ticking. We're looking at just a matter of hours now, but there is still plenty falling across the southeast. As we check the latest, we still have areas of moderate to heavy rain right across the southeast. I'd call it lighter showers on the Gold Coast at the moment, with the heavier rain staying inland from there. Severe storms have been dropping very heavy rainfall on areas north of Brisbane up towards the Moreton Bay region. The Bureau of Meteorology has severe thunderstorm warnings mentioning very dangerous storms for the area between Brisbane and Strathpine. Bracken Ridge has recorded over 700 millimetres of rain since yesterday morning. Creeks have been rising rapidly in this area today. Now, we can expect the rain to clear south this evening, then back to only isolated showers tomorrow. And of very much importance this evening for anyone near the Brisbane River, the Bureau's warnings are well under what we're expecting. We were expecting a 3-metre peak this evening around 8 p.m. That is already sitting at 3.28 metres. And we have almost 2 hours to go until that peak. We could see a major flood peak across the Brisbane River tonight, and tomorrow morning's is meant to be much higher. Sharon, this is starting to look a lot more like 2011.